Hi everyone, welcome to my another video. My name is Shirley and we are a professional plastic injection mold, die casting tool and production manufacturer in China. Today I would like to tell you about the most four common injection point or gate types for plastic injection mold. All these four gate types don't need to be trimmed after molding. It is time and cost saving. I have introduced another three common injection gate types which need to be trimmed last week. So go and watch it later if you haven't. By the way, if this is the first time you come to my channel and want to know more about plastic injection mold, toolmaking and die casting mold, you are in the right place. Start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss any of my new videos. Okay, let's get started.
Number 1. Banana gate. Some Europe countries called winkle gate, especially in the UK. Number 2. Sub gate. The full name is submarine gate or tunnel gate. Now you may have a question, where is the best place to make an injection point? Don't worry, I will tell you in a minute. Number 3. Pinpoint gate. Basically, the pinpoint gate is used in 3-place mold. All other gate types are used in 2-place mold. The cost of 3-place mold is higher than 2-place mold, of course. I'll tell you more details between 2-place mold and 3-place mold in the near future. Just hit the subscribe button now and ring the bell so you won't miss it. Number 4. Hot tips or hot nozzles with a hot runner system. I have introduced different brands of hot runner system in this video. Go and check it out later if you haven't.
So, where to make an injection point, I'm gonna tell you now. Actually, there is no specific place to make an injection point because it all depends on your product structure and the requirements of your product. But but basically the injection point will be placed in these three places. Please listen to me very carefully. Number one, the internal surface of product. Number two, the edge of product. Number three, the non-external surface of product. I mean, an invisible surface so that nobody can see it, as everyone wants to see a beautiful and a perfect product. I hope this makes sense. Okay, these are the most four common injection point or gate types, which don't need to be trimmed after molding for plastic injection mold. Plus, there are another three common gate types which need to be trimmed after molding. So there are seven common gate types for plastic injection tool. Did you get it? If you have any questions, put your comment below and I will answer each one of your questions. Also, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, give my video a like, and turn on the notifications so you don't miss any of my new videos. Thanks for watching, and I see you next week. Bye! Take care!